Good day to all of you children. In the last video, we saw what is a plane mirror, how images are formed with the help of plane mirror, what are the properties, and what are the number of images formed between two mirrors, plane mirrors if they are placed at a certain angle, and so many things we saw about plane mirror. It was a brush up of your class 8. Now we think about curved mirrors. So we will have two types of curved mirrors, children, convex and concave. So if this is a sphere with me whose radius is r, supposing, I will polish it from inside, outer surface will be rough surface, I will polish it from inside and I will cut out this much portion from the sphere. So I will have this type of curved mirror. This will be rough from outside, so I will hatch it like this, and this is polished side. So this becomes a case of concave mirror. And if I take a sphere like this and I make inside side rough and I polish it from outside, now the outer sphere is polished, and if I cut out this much portion, so this becomes a small piece of convex mirror because it is rough from here and polished from here. So this is a case of convex mirror. So in case of concave mirror, polished side will be on the cave side, cave, you know, so therefore the name concave. And in case of convex mirror, polished side will be outside, so this will be polished side, outer region. If you want to understand more, see, this is a spoon used in our kitchens. So if this surface will be called convex surface and this will be called concave surface. So this is a case of concave mirror if you are looking from here. And if you are looking from here, it is a case of convex mirror. So this is convex mirror, polished from outside, and this is concave, polished from inside. This becomes concave. So if you have understood nicely, let me show you the mirrors. This is a concave mirror, children. It is rough from here and polished from inside. It is polished from inside over here and rough from here outside. This is a concave mirror. And convex mirror, from the this side, concave side, it is rough. Outer side is polished. This is a convex mirror. So outer side is polished of the sphere and this side, inner side, is rough. In concave, the inner side is polished. This is the inner side that I am showing you, that is polished, and the outer side is rough, that you can see. So we want to study, children, how an image can be formed with the help of curved mirrors. With plane mirrors we have already seen. Now we want to see for concave and convex. So first of all, there are a few things that you need to understand. So supposing this is the sphere, children, and from inside it is polished, the outer side it will be rough like this. I cut out this much portion, so it becomes a case of concave mirror for me because it is polished from here. So this is concave, and as I told you, over here I polished it from outside. So this side will be rough. I do some hatching to make you understand and draw. I draw this much piece for you. This is rough. So this is the case of convex mirror. Now, children, there are certain terms associated with the curved mirrors. See, the center of the sphere, this from which the mirror has been cut, the center of that sphere somewhere over here, this will be called center of curvature of the mirror. Here the C is on this side, therefore C is over here. Okay, I am drawing like this. So first is, what is C? The center of curvature. So what will be center of curvature? It will be the center of that sphere from which this mirror has been cut. The center of that sphere from which the mirror has been cut, that point will be called the center of curvature for the mirror. So you can pause and write, children, what will be center of curvature? It will be the point, it will be the center of that sphere from which the mirror has been cut. That point will be called center of curvature. The center of curvature is the center of that sphere from which the mirror has been cut. ओके ज्योमेट्रिकल सेंटर ऑफ द मिरर. सो इफ दिस इज द मिरर चिल्ड्रन विद मी आई कैन सी दिस इज द ज्योमेट्रिकल सेंटर. ज्योमेट्रिकल सेंटर मीन्स लाइक सेंटर ऑफ सर्कल. तो फ्रॉम हियर इफ यू सी इट विल अपियर टू बी हियर इन द सेंटर. तो दिस इज द ज्योमेट्रिकल सेंटर ऑफ द मिरर वेदर कॉनकेव और कॉन्वेक्स दिस पॉइंट सेंटर पॉइंट. सो दिस ज्योमेट्रिकल सेंटर ऑफ द मिरर विच विल यूजुअली द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ दिस आर्क दैट विल बी कॉल्ड पोल ऑफ द मिरर. तो नेक्स्ट इज व्हाट इज पोल ऑफ द मिरर. पोल ऑफ मिरर. तो प्लीज पॉज एंड कॉपी एंड फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई हैव सेड. द ज्योमेट्रिकल सेंटर ऑफ द मिरर विल बी कॉल्ड पोल ऑफ द मिरर. ज्योमेट्रिकल सेंटर ऑफ द मिरर will be called pole of the mirror. Okay, the line joining the center of the sphere and the pole, the line joining the center of pole, center of curvature with the pole of mirror. The line joining the center of curvature with the pole of the mirror. This will be called axis of the mirror. So now we understand what is axis of mirror, or rather we call it principal axis of mirror. Principal axis of mirror. So what will be principal axis of mirror? The line joining the center of curvature and the pole of mirror. The line joining the center of curvature and the pole of mirror will be called the principal axis of the mirror. So please pause and copy, children. Please pause and write what is principal axis. The line joining the center of curvature and the pole of mirror. That is called principal axis of the mirror. The midpoint of PC, that is called focus of the mirror. Though this definition is not correct at this stage, but right now in class 10 you can understand like this. So what is F, the focus, rather the principal focus, or simply focus at 10 standard level, you can say. So what is F? It is the midpoint of PC. So midpoint of PC is called focus of mirror. So please write principal focus or simply the focus is the midpoint of PC. Radius of curvature R. Radius of curvature. It is what actually it is PC distance. So actually P is over here. And this is R, the radius of our sphere. Can you see that? So the radius of that sphere from which the mirror has been cut is called radius of curvature. So please pause and write. I am giving you the definition. The radius of curvature of the mirror is the radius of that sphere from which the mirror has been cut. The radius of curvature of the mirror is the radius of that sphere from which the mirror has been cut. And this R is equal to PC distance. Distance between P and C, the pole and the center of curvature, that is radius of curvature. So two things you can write for radius of curvature. One is the radius of curvature of the mirror is the radius of that sphere from which the mirror has been cut. Or it is the distance between pole and the center of curvature of the mirror. The distance between the pole and the center of curvature of mirror can also be termed as radius of curvature denoted by capital R. F, small f, that is focal length of mirror. Focal length of mirror. So what will be focal length of mirror? It will be distance between pole and focus. So distance between pole and focus of the mirror is called focal length of the mirror denoted by small f. So distance between pole and the focus of the curved mirror, that is called focal length of that mirror. So if all these are over, then we can pause and we can understand few more things. We have already seen what is center of curvature, what is pole of mirror, what is principal axis of mirror, what is principal focus, radius of curvature and focal length of mirror. Okay. Then see children. we have to understand the sign convention. The sign convention, this is very important. Okay, first I will do, children, we will form the images with the help of concave mirror and convex mirror, and then we will come to sign convention. Okay, we do that. Chalo, we try to form images with the help of a concave mirror and convex mirror. Children, you have to understand that laws of reflection which are true for plane mirror, they will be applicable for curved mirrors also, and they will be applicable for any type of surface. Angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection, and the incident ray, reflected ray and the normal, they will lie always in the same plane. These two laws will be applicable whether it is a curved mirror, plane mirror or whatever type of polished surface. So children, please understand that this is a concave mirror for me, hatched from outside, and this is the convex mirror for me. It is hatched from here. Understand that over here, this will be the focus, this will be the center, this will be the bowl, this will be the principal axis. This is the polished side, remember, for convex mirror, this is the polished side, and this is convex for me, and this is concave for me. This is the polished side. So object has to be in front of polished side, please remember. So this is the pole, this is the focus, and this is the center of curvature. Fine. Now children, you will understand 3-4 things when you want to draw the image of an object. I told you when I was discussing plane mirrors, to form an image we need at least 2 rays coming from the object. 2 rays you have to draw in any direction, you have to take the reflection, and wherever they meet, that is the position of image. If they actually meet after reflection, then they will give you a real image. If they don't actually meet after reflection, then you have to extend them in another direction, and that will give you a virtual image that you saw in the case of plane mirror. Same concepts will apply over here also. So before drawing the rays, please understand children, what are the methods to draw 2 rays to take the reflection and find the position of image. Always you can draw 1 ray parallel to the principal axis, and if there is a ray coming from object parallel to the principal axis, it will always pass from focus. Please remember these points. So if a ray parallel to principal axis is coming, then it will always pass from focus after reflection. All these things will prove when you come to 12th. Now this is polished side, the object has to be here, the rays will come from this side like this. Okay, and as I told you, upon reflection they will pass from focus. Now this is a opaque object, the ray cannot go over here, this is not transparent, the rays will be reflected like this. So in what direction the rays will go, that you have to decide. They can go like this, they can go like this, they can go like this, in which direction. So I told you that if the rays are parallel to principal axis, upon reflection they will pass from focus. So actually this ray cannot come over here because this is opaque object, it won't allow light to pass from it. But you will think that maybe the light was passing from focus like this, and then we take reflection in this direction. This is the direction of reflected ray, and we joined like this to understand that ray went like this and it is getting reflected. So it is passing from focus. Like this you have to understand, children. Please understand nicely what I am saying. So this is polished side, this is opaque surface, the light cannot come this side. So reflection is to be taken in which direction? So you take a scale, you join this point with focus, and whatever direction is there, in that direction you reflect the ray backward. So how to decide in case of convex mirror the direction of reflected ray? Like this you have to think. And now you would like to ask, children, okay, why it is happening like this? Is the angle of incidence equal to angle of reflection or not? So children, you will have to understand what is angle of incidence and what is angle of reflection over here. When the ray was striking over here, the normal is perpendicular to the mirror, that you know. So please children, remember, when you are having a curved surface, if there is a plane surface, then this is the direction of surface. But if it is a curved surface, then what is the direction of surface? It is different at every point because it is not a plane surface. So what you do is, at the point at which the rays are striking, you draw a tangent. What will be a tangent? A tangent will be a line which will cut the curve only at one point. I cannot draw line like this, I cannot draw line like this, because if I draw like this, it will go further and cut the mirror again. So I will try to draw a line which cuts the surface only at one point, maybe like this, a sphere is there, curved surface. At this point, tangent will be like this, at this point 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 like this. These are directions of tangents at different points. So when I am talking of this point, this is the direction of surface. At this point, this is the direction of surface. At this point, this is the direction of surface. At this point, this is the direction of surface. So you can see for a curved surface, direction of surface at every point is distinct. It is different. So if I try to draw a tangent, so maybe it will come like this. This is the direction of tangent. And then I draw perpendicular to it, because normal is perpendicular to surface. So perpendicular means I draw like this. It will pass from center. So this is the angle of incidence and this is the angle of reflection. You can see both are almost the same. Because children, when you study circles in class 10 in detail, our mirror is over here. This is the center. Any line which will pass from center will be direction of normal. Any line which will pass from center of the circle will be called direction of normal. So at this point, this is the direction of normal. Over here, this is direction of normal. Here, this is normal. Here, this is normal. So how to draw normal? Now you know. Just join the point of mirror with the center of curvature. That is the direction of normal at that point. So at different points, directions of normals are pointing in different direction that you can make up. So how to draw a normal for a spherical surface? I told you, join the point on the surface with the center. That gives you direction of normal. So you may not worry for the direction of surface, only join the point with center. This is the direction of normal at this point. Angle of incidence, angle of reflection equal. Here also the point was over here where the ray was striking. So join this normal, the point with the center. This is your normal. I draw like this. This is our normal. So if you draw properly, so this angle of incidence will be equal to angle of reflection. See. And therefore the ray goes in that direction. Understand nicely what is happening. So this blue line that I have drawn with different ink, that is indicating the direction of normal and angle of incidence. This is the incident ray, this is normal, this is reflected ray, I should be equal to R. Here also, this was normal, angle of incidence, angle of reflection. So first type of ray you can draw is, take a ray parallel to the principal axis and pass it from the focus. That is one way. Another ray can be like this. See, this will be our pole, this will be the focus, and this will be the center of curvature. This is, I am talking of concave only, and this I am talking of convex. This is the principal axis P, F, and C. This is polyside. So, as I took one ray parallel to the principal axis after reflection passing from focus, therefore, if there is a ray passing from focus, upon reflection it will become parallel to the principal axis. Both the things are there. If a ray is parallel to principal axis, then it will pass from focus. If it is passing from focus, it will become parallel to principal axis. Here also the same thing. If a ray of light is coming in such a way that it is passing from the focus, the light ray will come, it will come and strike the mirror like this. So actually it cannot penetrate, but we will think it is coming in direction of focus. So I draw it for you, maybe like this. There is a ray coming like this. See, it will pass from focus if we extend it. So light ray will come like this only. So this is the dotted line I am drawing. Only to show you that maybe it will touch the focus. So we will say this light is coming in direction of focus. The nodal element will become parallel to the principal axis, means it will become like this. Almost parallel to the principal axis. It will become parallel upon getting reflected. So any ray which is coming and passing from focus, upon reflection it will become parallel to the principal axis. Same thing over here. Again, if you want to see whether angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection or not, so you know that this is the normal direction. So this is I and this is R. You can make out both are almost equal. Here also at this point, this is the normal. This is the direction of normal. And if you extend it backward, this is my normal. So you can see this is the angle of incidence. Sorry, this is the angle of incidence and this is the angle of reflection. Ray coming like this and going back. So this I equal to R. you can see they are almost same. So two types of rays we have seen. If a ray is parallel to principal axis, upon reflection it will pass from focus. And if the ray is passing from focus, upon reflection it will become parallel to the principal axis. These two things I hope you can understand. Please, children, pause and copy. Please pause and copy. Okay. Then two more types of rays you are having. So again, a concave mirror like this. This is the principal axis. Here, this is the rough surface. This is the pole. This will be the focus. This will be this. Here, this will be polished side, as I have been telling you, for convex mirror. Here, this will be polished side. So, object is to be kept in the side of polished side naturally. So, two rays we saw. If parallel to principal axis, then passing from focus. And if passing from focus, then becoming parallel to principal axis after reflection. Now children, one ray which is coming passing through center of curvature, if a ray is coming like this, incident ray, then you know that this itself is the normal, because this is point Q where it is touching the mirror. So QC itself is normal, because I told you what is direction of normal. Join the point of incidence with the center of curvature. At whichever point your ray is striking the mirror, join that point with the center of curvature, that becomes your normal. That means your incident ray is in direction of normal. So what is the angle between them? Zero, because both are in the same direction. So angle of incidence is zero. So what will be angle of reflection? Zero. Angle of reflection is zero. Angle of reflection is zero. And what is the angle of reflection? Angle between the reflected ray and the normal, which you want to be zero. That means if this is the normal and this is the reflected ray, angle between them should be zero. That means both should be in the same direction. Then only this angle between these two fingers will become zero. So this is the reflected light and this is the normal. If they are not in the same direction, angle won't be zero. So if we want angle of reflection to be zero, then reflected ray and normal should be in the same direction. That means the reflected ray will come back in the same direction. Here you have to write I equal to R equal to 0 degree. Same thing over here. There has to be a line. Light ray coming and passing from the center of curvature. Again, it cannot pass from center of curvature because you know that this is the opaque surface, so light cannot cross this. But you will think that supposing the light is coming like this. See, if we extend it, then it will pass from the center of curvature. So light is coming like this and happening like this. So it is coming like this, and now because it is passing from center of curvature, it is in direction of normal. Angle of incidence is zero, so it will go back in the same direction. So here also I equal to R equal to zero. So one ray you can take passing from center of curvature and it will go back in the same direction, as I told you. So this was third type of ray. Fourth type of ray, children, you can take like this. This is pole, this is focus, and this is center of curvature. At this point, this is the normal, because P and C. At this point, this is the normal. So I draw here also. This is the pole. This is the rough side. This is focus. This is C. So at this point, this is the normal, because I told you what is normal. Join the point of mirror with the center of curvature. That will be the normal at this point. Okay. So I take one ray which is coming like this and striking the pole. So this is the angle of incidence. Normal and incident ray. So how will the reflected ray go? Making same angle. R equal to I. Like this it will go. And same thing over here. If any one ray of light is coming like this, let me draw it straight. If a ray of light is coming like this and making angle I, it will be reflected back in the same direction. I equal to R. And here also I equal to R, of course. So children, four type of rays you are having. One will be parallel to principal axis, pass it from focus after reflection. One will be passing from focus and make it parallel after reflection, parallel to principal axis. Third, I told you, if it is passing from the the center of curvature, it will go back in the same direction, whether concave or convex. And fourth, if it strikes the pole of the mirror, it will go back in this direction, making same angle I equal to R. So please pause and copy, children, these four diagrams. Please pause and copy to understand which type of four rays we can draw to form an image. Okay. Then see. Let us understand how image will be formed. First, with the help of concave mirror, let us see. So this is the concave mirror with me. This is the principal axis, the pole, the focus, and the center of curvature. Children, these two distances should be equal when you draw in exam. Take your pair of compass, what you call as rounder. Actually, it is not a rounder. We call it rounder because we think it is drawing rounds for us, so we name it rounder. Actually, it is not rounder, it is a compass. Compass means direction. So the point of that instrument is showing us some direction, therefore it is called a compass. So don't call it rounder. So anyway, take your compass and keep it at some distance and make a spherical surface like this. And then whatever point was there from which you had drawn this curved surface, you know, if you are having a book like this, there will be ruled line like this. I am showing you how to draw an exam. There will be ruled lines like this in your paper. So what you need to do, keep your rounder point over here. I am calling rounder so that you can understand. If I say compass, you will feel I don't know about which compass box I am talking. So anyway, take your rounder and put it over here. With the help of scale, you stretch it to some centimeters. Say 5 or 6 or 8, that is your choice. You can take any. And then you draw a curved surface. See, this is the midpoint of this line. So if you go till here, so how many lines you have gone? 1, 2, 3. So here also to 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2 and 3 like this. This will be your curved surface. So this was the principal axis. Don't take point on this line, otherwise it will not be seen. So take between two lines. And then 1, 2, 3. So here also 1, 2, 3. The spacing between lines will be equal, I believe. So this will be the curved surface. And then you can hatch it over here. So this becomes a concave mirror. If you do hedging over here, it becomes a convex surface. Then with the scale, you draw this line. This will become your pole. This will be as C, and the midpoint you choose as F. Like this, you have to draw an exam. So you will get a perfect figure. That is what I am telling you. So I showed you what you have to do in exam. C will come on this side also. Even if it is the case of convex mirror, hatching will be over here. The center will be on this side only, and focus also on this side. Even though this is the polished side in convex mirror, even if this is the polished side, focus and center of curvature will come on this side only. Please understand. Okay, so I showed you how to draw this piece of mirror in your books when you draw the image. So children, what you will think is that first we keep the object beyond center of curvature. So one line I take parallel like this and it will pass from focus. This is one. Second one I want, I may pass from focus or I may pass from C. If I pass from C, it will come back. So it is going like this. I have not drawn the mirror completely, so never mind, leave it over here and it will come back again in the same direction. So draw like this. So one ray going parallel and passing from focus, the second one passing from center of curvature, it will strike the mirror over here and come back in the same direction. So this is one reflected ray, this is the incident ray, one reflected ray, and this is incident as well as reflected. So two reflected rays are meeting over here. So this is the top of the arrow, this is the top of the arrow. And this bottom will be over on the principal axis only. So your arrow will be formed like this. So when the object is beyond the center of curvature, image is formed between center of curvature and focus, that you can see. It is inverted. The rays of reflection are actually meeting, so it is a real image. So real and inverted image we get. So I will write over here. I will plot this. And let us check. We want to see position of object, position of image, whether it is real, whether it is inverted, that all you will see. So position of object, that was beyond C. So this was formed between F and C. Yes, it is real because rays are meeting and it is inverted. Yes. So this was the first. Okay, first I am showing you for concave mirrors. Then you bring the object further, I place it on C. Do not forget to hatch to show it is concave or convex. The object is on C. The ray will go like this, incident ray. Do not forget to draw the arrows, that is very important. It will pass from focus like this. Other end will draw from the center of curvature, it will go from center of curvature. It will, the mirror will be over here, it will strike the mirror and come back in the same direction. Okay, going and coming back. So one reflected ray and second reflected ray, they are meeting over here. So this will be the position of the stop point. So the image will be formed like this. This is the image. It is formed exactly where it is C. So on C, the image is also on C. It is real and it is inverted. Okay, then we bring it still closer. We bring it still closer. This is the pole, focus C. Earlier beyond C, then C, then between these two. I keep it over here. Don't keep it near focus. Try to keep it near center of curvature. Even if it is between, don't make it between. Just shift a bit to this side. So between C and F. Why I'm saying that I'll explain later on. So one ray goes like this, parallel to the principal axis. It will pass from focus. This is the reflector ray. Do not forget to draw the rays. One will pass from the C. So it will go like this and it will meet over here. So actually the mirror is like this. The ray will come like this and go like this again. Understanding what is happening? So incident ray coming like this, passing from C, the center of curvature, and again getting reflected in the same direction. So this is one reflected ray and this is second reflected ray. They are meeting over here. So this is the top point of image which I have taken. So this is the position of image. So third, between F and C, so it is formed beyond C. It is real, it is inverted. Why it is real? Because the rays are actually meeting after reflection. Therefore it is real. So I need not draw this remaining portion of the mirror. I need not draw this. That is okay. For understanding I have drawn. So this also is okay. Then we shift it more on F. So this is F and this is C. I keep the object on focus. I draw one ray parallel. It will pass from focus. Another ray I have to take from C. It will go like this. And will touch the mirror and come back in the same direction like this. So children, you will observe that these two rays are parallel when you draw perfectly by taking proper measurements. So these two reflected rays will go parallel. That means they will never meet. So actually what will happen, children, that we are thinking the rays won't meet because they are going parallel. So we will think that they will meet at infinity. See, if there is one point at infinity and if it is emitting rays, so when they reach us, they become parallel because they have traveled a very large distance. Please understand this very important point. If there is a point object in the solar system or in our universe or in our anywhere near the cosmos that we live, whatever sun rays that you get, sun is very far away from us, it is a point object. So whatever rays are coming from sun, they are not parallel. If this is the position of sun, it is a point, it will give out rays in all the directions. So these rays are not parallel, please understand. If Earth is over here, then because these rays travel a great distance and come to us, these all rays, when they reach the Earth, they almost become parallel. You have to think like this. Because they are traveling a very large distance. So when rays travel a very large distance, they appear to be parallel. So they are appearing parallel to us, that means they will go and meet at infinity. Therefore, when the object is at F, the image will be formed at infinity. So I wrote all these things. So this concept you have to understand. Fourth, the object is at F, image is at infinity. Real image will be there, yes, because we will assume that both the rays will go and actually meet at infinity. We real image will be there and inverted image will be there. Inverted image will be there because real image, you can see it will be inverted. If actually we draw by pointing them, by making them intersect at infinity, you will find that image is inverted. So, children, please pause and copy, or can I show over here? Yes, I think I can show over here, the fifth image. Between pole and focus. Again, it was beyond C, then it came near C, then between C and F, then on F, and now between C and F, like this. So, when it is of P and F, draw it near the pole, don't draw near the F, because now you know, as I go near the F, the image will go to infinity, it will become difficult to find the point of intersection. Therefore, here when I was telling you, so when it is between C and F, I told you draw near C, don't draw near F, because as you come near F, the image will go to infinity, it will become difficult for us to find the point of intersection. Therefore, I said keep it close to C. Here also, when it is between F and P, try to keep it close to P, not close to F. Okay. So, this is the rough side for us. One ray going like this, it will pass from focus. This will be the direction. Another ray you take passing from C, it will go like this. So now I know, children, all these rays will diverge. So these two will not meet because they are diverging. So what I have to do, I have to pull them back and they meet over here. So the point is here and this point will be on the axis always. So the image, as you can see, it is rect, it is not inverted. The rays are actually not meeting, so it is virtual. So fifth point was between F and P, between F and P, the image is beyond P, it is real, no, it is inverted, no. These are the points. So please pause and copy, children, all the ray diagrams for a concave mirror. Please pause and copy, and all the tables please copy. Then we go to convex mirror. Children, for a convex mirror, this is your convex mirror. This will be rough side. This will be polished side. Okay, that you know. You know that this will be P, this will be F, this will be C. We take one object over here. Naturally, object is to be kept on the polished side. So now we cannot say object will be where, between pole and focus or what, we don't know. Because pole and focus and center of gravity are that side. We cannot keep object on that side. So we will think we are keeping object anywhere. So all these things go, the position of object. So we cannot keep it between C and F or F and C or whatever. The object will be on this side. It will be always beyond the pole. So beyond pole, position of object. Only one position is there. Beyond pole for a convex mirror. This is a convex mirror because you can see polishing is on this side. Okay. So I want to see the nature of image. One ray will come parallel to the principal axis. It will pass from focus. How to draw, children? Take a scale and pass it from focus and draw this line. And dotted line over here. Dashed line over here to show that it was coming like this. So now it is reflected like this. This is first ray. Another ray you can draw passing from center of curvature. It will go back in the same direction as we saw. So maybe like this, the point object here and this center of curvature, I fix them, then I draw a ray of light like this. Here full line and here only dotted line. So this was the incident ray and it will go back in the same direction. So this is first reflected ray and this is second reflected ray. I can see both are diverging, so real image can never be formed. And we can see they are getting intersected over here. So this will be the position of image. So what will be the position of image? You can see it will be between P and F always. Will it be real? No. Inverted? No. So children, please understand, very important point. This object, wherever you keep, however close, however large distance, the image will be always over here. in case of convex mirror. In case of convex mirror, the virtual image cannot go beyond focus. It will be always up to here only. As you come close, the image will come near pole. As you go far away, the image will go towards infinity. So, as you approach pole, write these points very nicely. As the object approaches pole, image, virtual image, approaches pole. As the object moves to infinity, the image moves towards focus. So image will be formed always between P and F. So image, virtual image, always between P and F, whatever be the position of real object. Why I am saying real object? That you will learn in 12th. Right now, write real object. So this is actually the object you have to worry about, the real object. The image will be formed always between P and F. So maximum distance of image from the pole can be how much? Focal length, because image cannot go beyond this. So maximum distance of virtual image in case of convex mirror will be how much? Only the focal length of the mirror. So this way I showed you how to form the image with the help of convex mirror. So today, children, we have seen what are the convex mirror, concave mirror, what is the pole, what is principal axis, what is radius of curvature, all those things we saw. How to make images with the help of convex mirror and concave mirror, these things you have seen in this video. Next time we will take up sign convention and we will take up some numericals. Thank you and God bless you, children.